And the next important kind of landforms associated with cycle of erosion are glacial landforms. Glaciers are mainly two types. A glacier is simply a moving mass of ice, and there are two types mainly. One is continental glacier, other one is valley glacier. Continental glaciers are found in regions like Antarctica, Greenland, etc., where the whole continents are completely filled with ice caps. And Iceland is the biggest continental ice shield. The valley glaciers are found in alpine mountain system like the Himalayas, Alps, etc. And a glacier is a moving mass of ice. In the erosional process, the most important process is played by glaciers, because the glacial erosion is the ones that supplies the debris to the fluvial erosion, that is to rivers. Rivers receive all their silt from mainly from glacially eroded material, like in Himalayas. The glaciers are charged with rock debris, that is, due to intense amount of pressure and weight, the ice carries a lot of debris below it, that is, it carries huge rocks. These huge rocks keep on striking against the lower strata, hence there is a lot of wear and tear in the lower strata, and there is huge amount of debris which flows from lower strata. This is because of pressure exerted by glaciers. And the one important glacier in India is Siachen Glacier, which is in border with Pakistan and China. And the glaciers become significant because they are the main sources for rivers like Gangotri for Ganga, Yamunotri for Yamuna, etc. And even rivers like Brahmaputra, which originate near Kailash range, are mostly served by glacial waters. So glaciers play a very important role in charging rivers with both debris as well as water. And coming to erosional landforms associated with glaciers, these are the major erosional landforms: glacial trough, creeks, Tarn Lake, Hans Arete, and then hanging valleys and waterfalls here and there. Let's take a look at all the erosional landforms in detail. The first one is creek or quarry, which is a hollow basin which is covered on three sides by land, that is slope of the river, slope of the mountain. And on one side it is open for the water to flow. And once the ice in this creeks melts, then it gives rise to a shape called tarn, which is very similar to creeks, but they contain ice. Instead of ice, they contain water. And the next one is glacial trough. Glacial trough is a stream which is formed due to vertical erosion as well as lateral erosion. In the whole glacial erosion, both lateral and vertical erosion plays a significant role. Hence, most of the valleys which are found, we see they are in U-shaped because of both vertical and lateral erosional processes. And hanging valleys are simply valleys which are present for smaller tributaries. This is the valley of major tributary, which is extended U-shaped one, whereas the other one is in the shape of U, but which is at higher terrain compared to the glacial trough. Hence, this is called a hanging valley. And Arete is a ridge which is formed due to erosion on both sides of the peak or ridge. As erosion becomes intense in both these regions, they take out a lot of alluvium or silt in the form of glacial debris. And the center region, which is not eroded, remains in the form of ridge, which is called as Arete. And when this arete is eroded on multiple sides, it gives rise to a structure called horn, which resembles a peak. And deep jawed is one is a kind of a structure which becomes similar to a river valley, as you can see in this figure, except that all the glacial debris flows through this valley into the sea. These kind of structures are found only in few countries like New Zealand and Scandinavian nations, where glacial action is important, and they are rare in Antarctic and Arctic, other Greenland, other regions. And the next ones are marine landforms. Intensity of marine erosion depends on various features like size and strength of waves. For example, waves are much higher in size in southern hemisphere compared to northern hemisphere because of less landmass in southern hemisphere, which facilitates wind flow at high velocities. And seaward slope also matters, that is, whether the sea is surrounded by a plain or a steep sides. And height of the shore between low and high tides. High tides greatly influenced the formation of marine landforms. Gulf of California, Red Sea, and such regions where the seas are enclosed, the tides are much higher. Hence, the landforms here are greatly influenced by sea tides. And the composition of rocks and other soils around the sea also matters. And depth of water, which facilitates ocean currents, also plays a major role in marine erosion. And coming to erosional landforms, the major erosional landforms are sea cliffs, wave cut terraces, blowholes, sea arch, sea cave, sea stack, and terrace kind of landform. And sea cliffs are the ones which are seaward limit of the coast. They are formed due to successive erosional processes where the higher standing landform is successively eroded from bottom to top, giving rise to a structure like sea cliff, which stands higher compared to the sea level. And these cliffs get eroded gradually, and the waves level out the shore region. That is, the waves started leveling out shore region like in here, and the sea cliff like structures remains for a longer period of time. And the wave cut platform is just a platform which is formed due to successive erosion of sea cliffs. For example, when the level of the sea was here, then this was a sea cliff then, and due to successive erosion and the upliftment of the land, the sea level has fallen, and we can see there are many sea cliffs one above the other, leaving a terrace like structure. This is formed mainly due to differential erosion due to subsidence of sea or upliftment of landform. And blowholes or sprouting horns are another important landforms which are absorbed where the beaches are rocky. Due to holes in these rock-like structures, the pressure exerted by the sea waves is seen as small explosions in these blowholes. And other important landforms are sea caves, sea arch, and sea stack, which are more or less formed by the same way due to differential erosion. Sea cliffs, where the strata is weak, is eroded, giving a cave-like structure called a sea cave. And if this sea cave-like structure is formed in between the ocean, then it gives rise to arch structure, which is called sea arch. And when one side of the arch is broken and falls apart into the sea, then the remaining section is seen in the form of sea stack. And coming to depositional landforms, the most major depositional landforms are bar and bay barrier, lagoons or sometimes estuaries, barrier spit, tumbaloo, and beach. The most important of all is beach. Beach is accumulation of minute sediment which is left after the wave action. And beaches are the main salient features which are important tourist attractions. And tumbaloo is a region where a bar or a marine debris is connected to a small island like a bridge, and this bridge like structure is called as tumbaloo. And a bar is one, it is a part of a submerged debris which is found below the overlying debris, and this overlying debris is called bay barrier. And the bay barrier might sometime enclose a water body which is called lagoon, which is mainly consists of saline water. One example is Chilka Lake in India. It is separated from the sea from this small barrier. And other one is barrier spit. Barrier spit is simply the debris which is accumulated, and it is connected to one side of the beach, whereas other side remains open for the water to enter. And this kind of structure is called as barrier spit. And coastlines are classified into different categories, mainly coastline of emergence, coastline of submergence, and based on the presence of these two kind of coastlines or absence. One is neutral coastline, other one is compound coastline. And there is another coastline called as fault coastline, which is different from these kind of coastlines. Coming to coastline of emergence and submergence, it is simply formed when whether the sea level goes below or sea level goes above. If the sea level goes above, then some part of the land is submerged. This gives rise to a coastline of submergence. At the same time, when sea level falls and when sea level recedes backwards, then we can see the appearance of the coastline which was further before covered by the sea. And this kind of coastline is called as coastline of emergence. This coastline of emergence or submergence are found mainly due to subsidence in sea level or the upliftment or subsidence of landforms. both cases are possible. And the main kind of landforms formed by coastline of emergence are bars, spits, lagoons, salt, beaches, marshes, sea cliffs, etc. And in the coastline of subsidence, there are other kind of landforms, namely Ria, Jod, Dalmatian, and other landforms. You can see these are examples of Jod and Ria. Ria is a smaller version of Jod. And this kind of coastline, that is coastline of emergence, is mainly found in east coast of India, especially in the southeastern part, that is near in the coastline of Tamil Nadu. And southern coast of western coastline is also part of coastline of emergence, for example Kerala coast. And the coastline of submergence is only found along the northwestern coast, that is Mumbai Gujarat coast. For example, Run of Kutch is an example for coastline of submergence. And coming to neutral coastlines, these coastlines are the ones where both submergence and emergence are completely zero, that is there is no submergence or emergence. These coastlines give rise to kind of regions like deltas, which remain there for millions of years. For example, for a delta to be formed, the region needs to be stable for millions of years. Thus, neutral coastlines facilitate the formation of deltas, etc. And also volcano coastlines, coral reef coastline like in Australia are also examples of neutral coastlines. And other one is compound coastline, where both submergence and emergence take place. And these kind of coastlines are mostly found in the coast of Norway and Sweden. And the fault coastlines are very rare, where a block is upthrusted or undergoes subsidence, giving rise to a fault coast, like in this figure. A block may be uplifted or it can subside, the neighboring block can subside, giving rise to a fault coastline. And the next important landforms are arid landforms. The cycle of erosion in arid landforms is mainly carried out by wind, and these are the major forms or landforms which are formed due in arid landforms. We can see some of these are erosional in nature, whereas others like bachans are depositional ones. And if you see erosional landforms, few rocks are found in desert regions which are shaped in the form of mushroom or umbrella shaped. These are called mushroom rocks. These are found mainly due to differential erosion. For example, wind carries more sand at the bottom near the surface. As a result, the rock at the surface undergoes more erosion. And the above rock, which is at a height from the surface, undergoes differential or less erosion. As a result, it gives rise to a mushroom-like structure. The other one is domiciles. These are formed in the same way like mushroom rocks, except that their shapes are quite different. And coming to major erosional landforms in arid regions, we can see the most important one is the plateau, which is a flat area with steep cliffs and narrow valleys. The plateau has a very hard rock on the surface. As a result, erosion here becomes less significant. And below the harder rock strata, this rock strata is softer, but as it is supported by harder rock strata, it is protected and doesn't undergo much erosion. But over a millions of years, erosion in this kind of rocks can be significant. Hence, under influence of erosion, there is one more kind of plateau which is formed, which is called as mesa. It is simply an isolated plateau. And wadis are simply dry gullies or river beds eroded by occasional flash floods. That is a river-like gully structures which is formed at the base due to huge amount of rains which carry out erosional processes along the valley floor is called as wadi. And butte is much smaller version of mesa, which gives life to a dome-like structure. Eiselberg is a resistant rock which stands tall and undergoes differential erosion. As a result, this remains over a long period of time, and it is quite different compared to the surrounding structures. Pediment is simply the deposition of all the debris which is eroded by wind, water, etc., which settles just below all these structures like plateaus and then mesa or butte. We can see these sediments are called as these are called pediments. The other important landform is Palaya. Palaya is formed due to accumulation of water during rains. and it gives like rise to occasional lake which is called Palaya. And Bajadas are another important regions which are formed between the fans or alluvial fans, which are alluvial fans. These are the alluvial fans where most of the silt is deposited, and between due to coalescence of these kind of fans, we can see these three fans coalesce. Coalescence of these three fans gives rise to a landform called as Bajada. And oases are other important features of deserts. These are not erosional landforms, but they are important features. And bachans are depositional landforms. We'll see in detail. And few other basic erosional landforms in arid areas are seen like rill, gully, ravine, badland, gorge, and canyon. Rill is simply a small stream of water flown structure which is left after intense erosional processes, and these rills becomes bigger and give rise to gullies. And gullies where vertical erosion is significant, the base of the gully is completely eroded, giving rise to a structure called ravine. And many such ravines over a mountain topography give rise to a badland topography, as you can see in this figure. There are many gullies and ravines all along the slope of these mountains. And gorge is the extended version of ravine where a V-shaped valley is prominent. And canyon is a U-shaped or slightly bigger version of gorge where due to successive erosion, these blocks fall into the sea and into the river, and these are successively eroded. And in canyon, though it is a kind of V-shaped valleys, but still the upper parts, upper sections are divided by much large distances. That is, upper landforms are divided by much larger distances. For example, Great Grand Canyon in along Colorado River in USA is one good example. And there are few rocks we have seen, mushroom and domiciles. Other ones are jejuen, which are bigger version of mushroom rocks, and adangs, which are simply ridge-like structures which are formed in semi-arid to arid regions, which are a continuous ridge-shaped landforms. These are mostly seen in China, that is near Gobi Desert. And coming to depositional landforms, sand dunes and loess are the important depositional landforms. Sand dunes are mostly found in intense desert landforms like Sahara, Thar, etc., whereas loess are found in semi-desert to arid landforms. Loess are a sedimentary deposits which are found mostly in Gobi Desert. And the final ones is karst landforms, are the landforms formed by erosional processes in limestone sediments. Different landforms are as seen in this figure. Stalactite and stalagmite are important examples for depositional kinds of karst landforms, whereas other ones are erosional in nature. Karst window is a cave-like structure which is formed due to differential erosion, and the biggest structure of karst window is called cavern. Sinkhole is simply a hole in which water completely disappears. This water flows below the limestone sediments where there are numerous streams inside. This is sinkhole. And bogas are more or less just other version of sinkholes, where even here the water disappears when the water flows into these regions. This is because limestone sediments are porous in nature, that is, there are huge amount of pores. As a result, after a certain period of time, the water starts seeping in through these pores and reaches the ground levels below the surface. As a result, in limestone sediments, water disappears in the form of sinkholes and bogas. And this is the end of cycle of erosion and associated landforms.